A brother's asking, how do I know I'm ready for marriage? If you don't know you're ready, you're not ready. That's really the simplest way of doing it. Now, the Prophet ﷺ actually does make a criterion for whether we know we're ready or not. He says in that beautiful hadith, ﷺ, مَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمُ الْبَاءَ, the one who's able and capable. And the commentators, they comment, able and capable, meaning financially, emotionally, physically, intellectually, capable in all respects. You know, you got your ducks in a row. You're in a place where you finished your education somewhat, you are making your own income, or you have people who will bankroll you. Alhamdulillah, some of us, we have families that are willing to look after us and provide us a place to stay. So, you know, don't look at it in that sense. Ready is not just simply physical. Many of us are ready physically, but if you're ready physically and you're not ready emotionally and, you know, you're immature, it's something that becomes sinful for you to actually burden yourself on a family and a new person who you are going to raise children with when you yourself are not yet ready to be there. Now, I want you to consider, you know, a lot of people, they say, oh, you know, we should encourage our, you know, be encouraged to marry really, really young. Well, actually, the Prophet ﷺ married at the age of 25, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam, according to most of the people of Sirah. That isn't the kind of, mentality that you see today from some 16, 17 year olds who are like, brother, I'm ready. Can you talk to my parents about it? So get ready. Get your education, get a place, get a plan, get an action plan. And I'm not saying don't take interest in someone that you and your family approach and kind of put on the low cooker if they're happy with that as well. Have your options available, but don't ever step forward to someone when you have not developed that maturity, that financial independence, that reliance upon yourself, which is necessitated and predicated by the Prophet ﷺ. If you're unable, the Prophet ﷺ continues in the hadith, فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِالصَّوْمِ, then I encourage you to fast. And the word fasting here isn't just you're fasting each and every day or every other day, as the sunnah of Prophet ﷺ, he said, don't fast every day, fast every other day. Why does he say fast? Because fasting is synonymous with sabr, meaning the Prophet saying, relax yourself, be patient, do the things that you need to do to endure with patience until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you a process and a capacity. And know that there were many of the Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ who had to wait and wait and wait. And once they had saved up and once they had found a little bit of prosperity, they stepped forward for marriage. May Allah allow us to find our life partners, our soulmates in this life that we connect with, and we connect with soulmates of our children and our parents until we meet together again in Jannatul Firdaus. Allahumma.